Hello, everybody. Let's try to get some post-game stuff done. Shogato. Move my bike, my mic a bit. Let me check the audio, see if it's okay. Yeah, oh god, it was okay. Just wanted to check. I was doing a little bit of the massive mass outbreak stuff for a bit. Oh. I'm gonna do a little bit of that before I continue the plates. I have something important to discuss with you. I heard an odd rumor. I believe it may be the key to unlocking the mysteries behind the massive mass outbreaks. You must first acquire 10 mushroom cakes and bring them to the secret hollow in the Alabaster Islands. I call this my tricky treat strategy. Just someone phone. I'll be waiting for you in the Alabaster Islands in the secret hollow. Buy some. I don't feel like taking any. Did 5, right? Was it 5? See if I got an email box first. I got 2. Seven, what, 3 more? Secret Hollow. Where's that at? Thank you. this. Okay. Did you bring me 10 mushroom cakes? Yeah, I brought the stuff. Well done. Mushroom cakes. Some quality ones at that. Now we're just getting started. Leave the rest to me. Return to Jubilite Village. I'll share how successful my strategy was when I'm finished. Okay. Let's see who needs what up. Don't know what that sound was. Oh, it's Arita. I was just about to go find you and tell you about this precious, incredibly precious thing I found. Be curious? Tantalized? Say so. Oh, come on, it's a treasure. If you don't take it now, those bandit sisters might get it first. Anyway, before I show you, can you guess what I want to do? Fight? Yes, exactly. I want to be able to achieve feats like yours. Like what you did atop Mount Coronet. Now, give me one moment. I need to center myself. Partners and I are going to get stronger, travel across this all across this wide world. Oh, and Espeon. Oh, and Flareon? Oh, okay. Get Espeon first. Duskwar is leveling up really fast. I wonder, are people even stronger than you out in the world? Pokemon stronger than yours? I'll just have to find out for myself, I suppose. Here, the treasure I promised you. Lustrous Globe. Used on Palkia, this large glowing orb wells with power and allows Pokemon to change form. Oh, okay, cool. I'm told this once belonged to the founder of the Pearl Clan. It's somehow connected to the Almighty Sin, to Mighty Palkia, I mean. And since Mighty Palkia is with you now, I'll entrust the Lustrous Globe to you, too. Thank you for everything. Hell yeah, I can make money. Does this guy want to do balloon stuff again? Probably does. Oh, Leon. What? Leon. I had a visit from... Oh, God. I'm so sorry. He came all the way just to boast about giving you some aguaberries. He said you lit up with so much joy that your smile nearly split your face. I can't imagine that was the case. I'm sure it was a confused grimace or a smile you merely forced yourself to give him out of pity. Fucking savage. But I still can't let myself be outdone by him. So I've been looking for you all over history. To give you this, my very own reward to you. It is, naturally, far superior to anything Melly can offer. Oh, nice. You gave me more. Oh, and I did see one of those massive mass outbreaks on my way here to find you. I wonder if they might be caused by the geology of this, the place where they occur. Perhaps there's some kind of mysterious... There's some mysterious kind of stone in the ground which draws Pokemon near. Oh, and I had a message from you from Mai. She would like to meet you in Jubilife Village. Yeah, she's been waiting there for you. Though, I suppose it's more accurate to say that she's been chatting away with Tsumugi from the Security Corps about Bidoof. As for me, I think I may visit the hot spring since I've come all this way. Do be careful of any massive mass outbreaks as you head back. Strong Pokemon might appear. Oh yeah, no, you just want balloon games. Garchomp is done. I guess Flareon. I got a cat. Do I have Flareon? My. I don't think I caught Flareon. Have I? No, I have. Sell some of this stuff. I walked right past her, didn't I? Yes, I did. No, I don't want to talk to you. My, my, what's on your mind? What in the world are you talking about? Mushroom cakes and strategies? Come to think of it, Irida also came to me with an odd request. She asked me for hearty grains, so I gathered some for her. Oh, is this a Zoroa pulling pranks? Could there be some Pokemon taking the guise of people to stir up mischief? None of this is why I called you here, mind. I meant to tell you that a massive mass outbreak has been reported in the Coronet Highlands. The next step in our research is to investigate the Coronet Highlands. Let's see what we can find. Could be a Zoro or a Zoroark. Or actually, no, since there was like a little Munchlax, it could be Zoroark and a Zoroa working together. Sneaky little shits. Now then, let's continue our investigation to these outbreaks here in the Coronet Highlands. Oh, you! I heard here because of a vision of my clairvoyant showed me. Some poor soul was running for their life from a bunch of alphas. Just barely saved them. It's as I feared then, these massive mass outbreaks really are going out of hand. We must endeavor to find the truth behind why they keep happening. Big packs of Pokemon might not be much trouble if you got a trusty partner, but if you don't. I'm scared just thinking about it. You did well to save that person, Sabi. You're as fine a protector as any lord or lady Pokemon. Thanks, Mai. If my clairvoyance shows me anyone else in trouble, I'll do my best to save them, too. And just be careful while you're out here, okay? She's right. I know how strong you are, but we should move with caution here. Alright. Oh, right, right. Let me feed the Munchlax. Anyone with file. Ooh, Clefairies. Oh, and, Dartrix? Well, I want to get Clefairies. I haven't caught one yet. Pick up. No, I'm going the wrong way this way. Fable. Catch you too. Ahem. Hell yeah. I knew I was gonna miss. Damn it. To next. That's a lot of mimes. Wrong neighborhood. Oh, hello. Where am I going? Wrong button. Really gotta go the long way around. Yep. Damn it. Where's Maya? Take over. Oh, right. Fairy's done. Where's she at? Guess I gotta go back out in the map. See what Paulina wants, because she wanted me to talk to her at Firespit Island. Alright, I can just teleport there. What am I doing? Seems Arcanine has settled to his role as Lord quite nicely. He's learned how to control his frenzied might and can use it in battle at will. Still, I'm sure you two could learn much from each other. What would you like to do? Oh, you want to fight? Oh, we can... I see. So we can do... We can do this again. That's what this is. Okay, I was just... Hey, the music. Nothing I can do here. Try and stay out of trouble. Yeah, nothing I can do. Can I skip the cutscene? Oop, I didn't want that. So I can rebattle anytime. I can't skip. Oh, I have to hit start and skip. Oh. Was it sunny day today? What is sunny day? Oh, hello. Hello, thank you for coming so far out of your way. Warden Iskin, wasn't Lena joining us? Oh, yes, about that. It seems she wanted some time with her lord, so she's asked us to check the lava dome sanctum without her. What? The nerve of... She knows I can't stand sweltering places like this. I'm sure she meant no ill will. The warden of the Lord of the Isles is such a kind, gentle soul. Anyway, shall we go? Might as well get this over with. Oh fuck, it's Heatran. Bo-bo-bo-bo-bo-bo-bo. Careful! Oh god, it's chasing me. I guess I was supposed to do that. There we go, that's good. Take one for the team. They're getting that damn Pokeball Heatran. Hell yeah. Iron plate. Stone tablet imbued with the essence of steel. When used on certain Pokemon, it allows that Pokemon to gain the power of the steel type. At least the heat's let up a bit. Both Arcanine and Heatran spewing flames about on a volcanic island. It certainly does get a bit toasty. Or Niskin. I have to ask. Do you think there was any need at all for me to be here? Yes, of course there was. After all, you are the leader of the Pearl Clan, and this trouble cropped up right around the seat of one of your clan's nobles, so, yes, it was surely best for you to come see to it. Admirable of you to look after your clan's affairs. Do you really think so? I was wondering if it might not be revenge for all the times I pushed Lena to train her Growlithe harder. That's surely not the case. Even if Warden Paulina may have mentioned something about the need for, tough love. I thought so. I think she was so patient and kind with Growlithe, but it comes to me. Well, you did great. We'll, just head back ahead of you then. Based on Kogita's hints, there seems there might be three more plates left for you to find. At least they have these balls of mud here to help out. Music's pretty good. See nine tails, but I've yet to see a Vulpix here. We caught Vulpix, so let's fight it. It's a little Garchomp. Vulpix would be somewhere up here. But you can't fly over lava. That's kind of a little weird. Okay, I just wanted to look around. Let's take on one of the pixie Pokemon real quick. Lake Trio. Thank you. Arceus' spirit. I was looking for that one. Is there another one over there? Yeah, there was one over there. Oh, Ninetales is done. Let me sell off those pieces real quick. There you are. Now what we got? We got Rowlets and Gibbles. All right, I'm going for the Rowlets and Gibbles. Which guava berries do I have still? Oh, I got buttload. All right, so. This is gonna be one heck of a travel. That's it, right there. I see him. See anywhere to hide, though. Ow! That hurt. damn it. I got terrible aim. Just covered. I need to start getting those rowlets. Seems to have formed. Not gonna gabite. Alright, now for the rowlets. South. Here they are. Thank you. I do want that alpha relic. I caught enough. Hey, you two are. Hope your investigation's going all right. There are folks in our clan and the Crow Clan are all helping investigate these massive mass outbreaks, or whatever you call them. I'm hauling my dog Wetzel. But what kind of leader would sit back and do nothing while you're all working? So I'd figure I'd grab whatever supplies I could find and that might come in handy for you. Here, my materials for those sticky glob things. What? Don't make fun, Maya. I'm trying to help. You misunderstand me, Adamant. As the sister who helped raise you, I'm truly proud to see how far you've... Oh, wait. Oh, I didn't know they're sibs. Listen, I've been wondering. Do you think these massive mass outbreaks could be some sort of trial from Mighty Dialga or Mighty Palkia? I guess. It kind of feels like it, right? As if someone's telling us, you've got the guts to face a real test with your partners. Take on these Pokemon, otherwise stand back. I would like you to see it that way, Adamant. Yeah, well, I'd love to stay and talk, but I've got an appointment to keep with that Benny fellow. I've been trying to get him to teach me his tricks. His cooking? Or his ninja skills? His cooking. I want to know his recipes and his ninja tricks. Once I do, I'll give you a proper demonstration. In the meantime, stay safe as you investigate. My, my. It seems having a trusted partner causes one to view these outbreaks in a rather different light. Now then, the Alabaster Islands still await. One more steep hurdle for us to overcome. Oh, damn it, I should have said Munch. It appears Munchlax is eager to continue as well. We'll await you at Jubilife's front gate as usual. Join us when you're ready for another survey. I don't know what my reward was. I closed out of it so fast. Holy shit, I got so many rare candies. I can work on that alpha Rowlet. Is my Decidueye I have. Okay. Got some seeds of mastery. Oh, there it is. There's the alpha Rowlet. Look at all these rare candies. Alright, let's evolve it first. Dapper fella. Can't eat all of them. Have you catch up with the team? All right, you're out. bigger you are compared to my other decision. You are a big boy. I'll work on them a little later. All this crap. This later. I'm going to be right back. Okay, I'm back. All right, Alabaster Islands. Old air seems to cut right through you. Wait, boy. Oh no. What are you two doing here? I came to advise you that the mass outbreak seen here in the Alabaster Islands seems slightly different than the others. The outbreaks happen during rainstorms in other areas, but here they seem to be tied to blizzards. Blizzards, you say? Could be just the cold environment, of course, but I have to wonder if there's more to it. Well, we better get to it. I think we should look into more outbreak locations than usual this time. I know increasing the scope of our investigation is a lot to ask at this point. Even for someone with your skill, it'll take a long time to check so many areas by yourself. It's a good thing I'm here to help you out then, isn't it? No, go away. Fuck off. Hey, Otterton, what's up? And I suppose even Leon might be of some use. Can I... God damn it, I just want to tell this dude to fuck off. I appreciate Leon's help. Fuck off, Melly. This will be your first time investigating these outbreaks, won't it, you two? Can't make up the hangout a while? Alright, yeah, I'm just doing some post-game stuff to pass the time. Alright, sum up. Drug culture of both just... a lot better than I have in the past few days. A lot better. We'll just focus on three areas, as he's been doing till now. Meanwhile, Sligu and I will handle the remaining areas. There's something wrong with your math there, little man. You left me out of the equation. No, his math's right. So, you can do basic math, can you? I know how to subtract you from this assignment, for starters. I'll finish all the remaining areas on my own. You needn't factor in. I can't tell if they hate each other or if they're both enjoying this. Either way, I imagine they never would have crossed paths if it hadn't been for you. For now, let's focus on investigating the outbreaks here in the Icelands. Where's the little Munchlax? Oh, there he is. Alright, so... what is in these outbreaks? Oh shit! Is Oshawott here? Oh yeah, there's Oshawott right there. It's a bit of a journey. As I go here, I catch a bunch of Oshawott. Alright, so let's go here. And head south. Yeah, Avalon's legacy. Show me the little otter boys. I just passed them. There they are. Oshawott outbreak. I like these fellas. These guys are cute. Look at these two little inky boys run at me. I catch so many of them. Catch that alpha. Gosh, what? I'm gonna try and use an ultra ball, because if I attack it, I might end up killing it. Done. I'm gonna throw this. Organize my pack. Alright, where can the next one be? Go get the routes. Oh, there they all are. At least there's some places to hide. Ow. God damn. To next. I guess I can get mischievous. Or I can go to the Heart Crag. See maybe if there's a possibility of what's his name? Yeah, why not? Yep, and there it is. That's the possibility I was looking for. Come on, head over here. I'm gonna catch you. Samurott. Yep, alright. That's I remembered it right. I just couldn't think. 62. Why does that samurai look so cool? It does look cool. Yeah, I like the Hisuian version. Yeah, with the black and red. Oh no, I killed it. Well, I killed it. Well, maybe some of these I catch, I can probably just evolve it. Alpha one. Yeah, I'm gonna catch this one. That way we can get a big Ocelot. Or Samurott. Yeah. Oh, hey! You got a chance of catching it after all. Come on, get in the ball. This guy does not want to get in the ball. In the ball, Shinji. That one didn't want to get caught. I don't care. Oh, citrus berry. There are more? Oh yeah, there is more right there. Oh, you're still alive. Let's see, there should be more otter boys. What if I could spawn another samurai? Drop citrus berries, so I don't mind farming them this way. We're gonna spawn. Oh, far for citrus berries. Oh, there's a snover over there. I haven't caught Snover yet. This way. Heading. Go south from here. Wrong one. Oh, Alright. Now I can head back. Oh wait, no, I don't want to head back just yet. See if I can catch him. Don't kill it. Yeah. Two more light Pokemon left to be caught. All right, that's that. So you finished checking the three areas you were charged with the Icelands. I've gotten word from Melly too. He says he's about ready to wrap it up. Lian said he and Melly worked together to investigate the last outbreak. Well then, seems we're done here. We've worked tirelessly to investigate all across Hisui. We still don't know what causes these massive mass outbreaks. Pose a threat to anyone without strong partners at their side. It'd be nice if these outbreaks didn't put anyone in danger, but things rarely work out that easily. Perhaps these outbreaks are someone's way of telling us that we better understand the Pokemon with which we share with Bass Hisui. Yeah, I could get behind that idea. But for now, we better get going if we want to make it on time. Morning, you two. Oshawott's done. Artrick's done. Decidueye's done. Infernape's done. This is the place. And we picked the perfect time. What do you think?
It's pretty.
This lovely place, noticed by mighty Palkia. This fleeting time mighty Dialga gave us. Such a beautiful view is only possible because we have both together. This way means so much to me. My love for it is as vast as the land itself. Tell me, do you enjoy surveying this land once again? That was fun. Was it? I suppose it's always thrilling to have a mystery to delve into. I enjoyed it, too. I've heard these massive mass outbreaks trigger some kind of reaction in your Munchlax, Mai. Is he doing alright? He seems fine. How come on remain mysterious creatures to us? Who's to say how he does it? I'm just grateful to him for helping us find the outbreaks and telling us what we'll find at each. That reminds me, I've spread word that the people of Hisui should be alert for massive mass outbreaks during rainstorms. Thanks for that, Irida. Hopefully no more poor souls will wander to one unprepared and take a beating. It seems like our lives are going to keep on changing. We'll keep adapting just as fast. Ever-changing history. Tell me, how do you think the future people of history will live with Pokemon?
They're bad on gyms.
Gyms? What is a gym? Why would you battle on one? They say there are places where you can challenge a skilled battler to prove your mettle. Interesting. I'd like to be the one who deems a challenger worthy. Well, whatever may come the future, are we lucky to have been born into such fascinating, fast-changing times? You said it. Not that change is always good, and there will always be people who don't want change at all. Hey, that's life. We'll just have to work hard and push on. And I'm glad we'll have you with us as we do it. Thanks for everything. You certainly have some curious ideas, but I suppose that's no surprise, coming from someone who fell out of the sky. We may have finished our investigations for now, but Munchlax and I will continue to help you however we can. You know, perhaps these new outbreaks truly are just a gift from Almighty Sinnoh. A gift meant for you, for all the good changes you've brought to all of us here in Hisui. Oh, XL candies. Welcome back, and fine work with your surveying. Pardon the imposition, but would you follow me to the training grounds? Did you finally remember stuff? I called you here for one very specific reason. I wish to have you try your hand at a new form of Pokemon battle. I used to think that Pokemon were terrifying creatures. You've helped me see otherwise. Thanks to you, there are some in this village who now enjoy battling with Pokemon. More and more of us now see Pokemon as allies. It's for that very reason that I would like you to continue... I'd like you to continue to further your trailblazing. I believe that taking part in a new form of battle will help deepen our understanding of Pokemon. In the midst of a tough battle, what does your partner desire? And what is your opponent thinking? I believe that you have the ability to sense these things, and we will do our best to learn as well. This is quite a difficult request we have for you, but I'm sure you're up to the challenge. You may ask Ingo here for a more detailed explanation. I'll leave the rest to you, Ingo. Please let me know when you're ready to try your hand at these new battles. I'm good. Who are you? A quest? Solitude of what? Oh, alright. Path to Solitude, a chance to master the art of battling with a single Pokemon. Battling a tough opponent with just one Pokemon in your party feels like reaching for the stars. You really gotta know your Pokemon well so you can come up with the best strategy. Oh, okay. God, man. I don't have Bastiodon. Need to catch that though, but I need a space-time distortion to have a chance to catch it. Alright, let's go find those plates. We're done with this other side quest. Dawnstone. This later. No, no tumble stones. I hope. this ear dead doing here? Hello again. I felt your presence nearby while I was playing my flute earlier. I came to play for the Diamond Clan so they can hear the melodies my clan holds dear. Oh, but seeing you here reminds me. I've learned more about the lustrous globe. It seems to hold the power to transform mighty Palkia to its otherworldly form. You can believe that. Listen, I want to battle mighty Palkia. I want to prove myself that when the Pearl Clan worshipped mighty Palkia, thinking was almighty Sinnoh, our belief, at least, was real. Please help me do this. Oh, I don't have him in my party right now. But I'll do that later. Let me... go... Like the anime RE0? I don't think I've seen that. But, I could probably add that to the list of animes I need to check out. RE0, that sounds familiar though. Let me double check. No, I haven't. You think it was a huge while ago? Save.
Forefathers, one and all! Bear witness!
Thank you for the follow, a bit of everything. It's an isekai anime, so, let's see. I'm gonna put that on my list to watch. I remember, you know that. Somewhere like when Rabbit was a thing, we watched like what? No Game, No Life? I think that was on Yui's Discord though. Yeah, we watched a few episodes back then. Alright, one more. Thank you. Perhaps I'll swap out for Palkia. You. I don't even remember what box I put them in. That's the Alga. There he is. Oh, I think he's referring to No Game, No Life. being old. Oh, here it is. Weird look. Okay, you were here. There she is. It's floating over the ground. What? Oh. Oh, you want... You wanted Justin in my party. Okay. Well, pup, what you want? Don't trust me. Right. Infernape. Now we go back. Step forward into this great wide world takes bravery and determination. With Glaceon. Thank God he didn't use ice moves. Comes down. Hit it, damn it. Hit the damn thing. Finally. It's actually kind of cool looking. Sheer power of mighty Palkia. It's as unfathomably vast as space itself. I'm in awe before it. It was incredible. Must have been the Pearl Clan's mighty Sinnoh. Looks like the Pearl Clan's leader can really hold her own in battle, too. Did you hear that? The people of the Diamond Clan praised our almighty Sinnoh. And they praised mighty Palkia. I want to take the spirit of respecting and cherishing one another and spread it throughout the vast history. And I'll do it through battling. I've decided on behalf of the entire Pearl Clan. We will bring our battles to Jubilife Village training grounds to let these ideas flourish. So many ice stones. Who's over at the lake? Oh, there's Adamant. Oh crap, I'm probably gonna have to battle him too. Let me change my shit out. That would have been awkward. Wait, no, I don't want to rest. Oh crap, where did I put- oh, here it is, Garchomp. Lake. If it isn't Drunk Vulture, good timing. I found some treasure you'd be interested in. Did that make your ears perk up? Happy to fill you in if you're curious. I don't really care. There's the Survey Corps, Spirit. Curiosity what moves science forward, according to good old Mr. Professor. But come to think of it, what I found seems too valuable to just let you hold on to it for free. Oh, just to let you in on it for free. It'd work a little. Here's the deal. I want you to show me what's in your mind, your heart, your soul. In short, battle me. Okay. Then it's on. Time to see what you got. Here I come, knowing full well how tough you are. Future of the Diamond Clan. Hey, he's got Umbreon and Corviknight. still alive. Something. And I'm a man of my word. So here's that treasure. Used on Dialga, this large glowing gem wells with power and allows the Pokemon to change form. This used to be my grandfather's. He said it was somehow related to Almighty to Mighty Dialga. Now that I've put you through a ringer a little, it seems right to give it to you since you're the one who caught Mighty Dialga. You know what I tell you? I'm glad it was you who fell out of the sky to us. Taught me another way to get along with Pokemon. Another way to relate to the world. Alright, now I can get going. To the next lake. I thought I have one. All right. Oh, that's almost done. All right. And go back to the village. Sell some shit real quick. No, I can use these to make star pieces. I'm gonna be right back real quick. I'm gonna refill my water bottle. Okay, I'm back. There we go. That's been bothering me for a while. Alright, now for that next lake Pokemon. Crap, I forgot to save again. No, you do that. I hate when a Pokemon uses recovery. Back and forth. They'll run out. Don't you dare use recover again. Yeah. have to run out of recover soon. I'm gonna wait until they run out. I think they finally ran out of recover. This is not very effective. Let's do this. Just to get into the red. Fine. That one put up a fight. Obtain the Draco Plate. Stone tablet imbued with the essence of dragons. Used on a certain Pokemon, it allows that Pokemon to gain the power of the dragon type. There are two more plates left to find. Snowcoin Temple, Moonview Arena. Okay, over there. It used basically all its damn moves. You still want. wieldy armor. What's that? Oh, it's an Evo item. Okay, yeah. No? I don't want to mess a mouse up frequently. Here, maybe, because I'm still trying to find a Vulpix. I mean, if there's a Ninetales, then there could be a Vulpix. That wasn't here. It was. So I have to go here anyway. What's up, little dog? Cleffa, I can catch that. Elekids. Now let's go catch Cleffa. Don't have that one. Getting there. There they are. Sniped. Level 60 Cleffa. That's a big baby. speed up this baby. The baby run away. Oh yeah, Moonview Arena. Ugh, this chuckle fuck. I don't suppose a grunt like you would even know, but I guess it behooves me to ask. Do you know the Pokemon called Cresselia? Yeah. Well, I figured you'd know. Wouldn't expect any less from someone who managed to defeat me, even if it was just a fluke. Cresselia is said to be the very embodiment of the crescent moon. Her feathers are called lunar feathers. Legend says that if you hold one as you fall asleep, you'll be visited with wondrous dreams. I call her a nightmare, that pesky Cresselia. She descended upon Moonview Arena and caused my lord to hide itself away. So worried about Electrode that I can't even sleep. Never mind dream. I think you might be able to catch Cresselia and perhaps even claim one of those lunar feathers. Oh, do catch that pesky flying croissant. Do it for my poor Electrode. Though I suppose Cresselia can't be all bad. She at least recognizes the perfection of the arena, looked after with loving care by the great Melly. Oh, you wouldn't even let me have a chance to save. Thing has feathers. Nope. Oh, I'm confused. Oh, God, it's like with Malfestio in Monster Hunter. It reverses your controls. Psychic type, okay. Oh, better not have recover, I swear to God. Oh, fuck, Of course, we gotta get ones that heal. Don't kill it, please. This whittle it down to the red. Run out of heals. gosh. I don't know how much PP Lunar Blessing has. Red. Please don't. Of course you do. Leon, heal him up. Make more max potions. I don't want Weekend to then accidentally kill it with the frostbite. Thank God. Suck. Attain the dread plate. Stone tablet imbued with the essence of darkness. Use a certain Pokemon, it allows that Pokemon to gain the power of the Dark type. Oh well, this is unexpected. Instead of a lunar feather, you've got some kind of plate. I do feel power emanating, though. In any case, if Cresselia did not gift us with any of our feathers, then I suppose she thought we had no need for them. Not bad at all, Grunt. Though, I suppose anyone with enough luck, the best the Great Melee, should be able to handle at least that much. Thinking about it, a halfway competent person like you might actually make a decent sparring partner to help my lord and I grow stronger still. You can fuck off. I'll go back to the settlement and tell the others about the feathers that we didn't get. One more. Crystallize all done. Oh, Togekiss is all done. Am I missing only two out of the Crimson Marlins? I don't know how much Pokemon there are in total. Next one was... Oh right, the temple. Oh? It's over here. I just want to see what's over here.
Does anything work well?
Bunch of guava I got. I got tons. Nothing super special. Okay. No, it was in a winter area. Alright. I'm having brain farts today. It was in the wintry area. Oh! Alright, let's see if we can get a Vulpix in this elf break. In the fire area, too. No Growlithe either. Okay. Alright, I'll ignore the other outbreak, so we'll just go over here. Oh, this braviary that's flying up there. I can catch it from the sky. Alright, I don't have a jet ball. Oh, no. Alright, should be in the bottom, they said? I'm gonna save this time, because I keep forgetting to. What's this? Oh no. I thought that was a broken wall. There was a downstairs. Yeah, right here. Why am I floating? Oh, wouldn't expect to run into you up here, Drunk Vulture. What are you up to? Here to try to find the secrets lurking in Snowpoint Temple, aren't you? That's what my clairvoyance told me. You do tend to get mixed up in all kinds of strange going-ons. Store here. Well, they say behind it sleeps a Pokemon so great it could tow around the entirety of the continents that lie to the south. No matter what we do, this door just won't seem to open. You have a hint? Stone plate, iron plate, and icicle plate you're carrying are reacting to the door. Oh, that's what those slots were. Oh, and now they're gone. Oh, Regigigas. Body is Reggie. What in time is that thing? It's colossal. It sure seems to be a Pokemon, but Let's see what my clairvoyance has to say. Yep, definitely a Pokemon. My clairvoyance showed me a vision of it in motion. Please don't have any recovers. Okay, yeah, you are a normal type. Don't kill it. I want to use an Aura Sphere again, but I don't want to kill it. I'm weakening it. Don't kill it. Oh! Oh boy. Magic pixels. I swear to God, if you have an attack called, if you have a double edge, I'm gonna be so salty. Oh, come on. Oh, please don't recoil. Okay. Get in there, please. Stone tablet imbued with the essence of normalcy. Used on a certain Pokemon, it allows that Pokemon to gain the power of the normal type. Now that was one solid Pokemon. A giant born of the very earth. I guess this is part of your job with the Survey Corps, huh? What kind of Pokemon is the one you just caught, hmm? I can't wait to see the Pokedex when it's done. Yeah, I'm pretty curious to read everything Mr. Professor writes up, too. See ya. We should do another chase sometime. Alright, now we gotta go back to Kogita. Okay, now we gotta head out to Kogita. Hmm. You are again. Have you collected all the plates? Of course. Dr. Bulger is a famed member of the Survey Corps, after all. So what more can you tell us? We're so close now. You must know more about the plates. If there's yet more you want to know, kindly bring me wood. 3 logs will do. Wood? So you're saying wood is somehow tied to the plates? Well, I suppose that's what we get to learn next. Hop to it. Well, shames me to admit it. Merchant that I am, I'm quite out of wood in my stores right just now. Got some right here. I think I got some. Yep. Oh, yes, this certainly ought to do. The moment comes at last, the big reveal. What, pray tell, is the secret behind this wood? Secret? Your expectations need tempering, my fear. This wood is merely for fashioning myself new cutting boards. Cutting boards? You mean for cooking? The plates we're after aren't dinner plates, so this is hardly time for cooking. You complain for one shirking his own work this very moment. Poor Ginter of the Ginkgo Guild must have his hands full with you. But honest work earns honest pay. Here you are, a reward for the wood you've brought me. Pixie Plate. Stone and tablet imbued with the essence of fairies. Used on certain Pokemon, it allows that Pokemon to gain the power of the fairy type. God damn! Apologies. That's indeed one of the plates we've been searching for. What do you mean a plate? Let me see that again. This does rather look like one of the plates you've been tracking down. While the engravings upon it made it less than accommodating as a cutting board, whatever ingredients crossed it certainly gained a more pleasant flavor. Perhaps that was the board's power. The plate's power, rather. Well, no more need saying. What do you two intend to do now? Well, we've managed to collect quite a lot of plates by now. I still don't know what we're to do with them exactly. It's just a hunch, but perhaps we should have a look around Celestica ruins? Those ruins contain statues of both Dialga and Palkia. They might hold more secrets. I see. Find pretext to continue shirking your mercantile duties to crawl about in old ruins, as you so enjoy. On with you, then. I don't need you to tell me. I'm going. Celestica Ruins. I'll see you there. Go on now, to the Celestica Ruins. I'm curious myself what you'll find there. What can we who live now learn from the remains of our ancient myths and legends? I thought it was over at the other place. Oh, I went to the wrong dang spot. Have a look at this. I see feet. This statue has been kept here far from the statues of Dialga and Palkia. Broken and shattered, yet it remains. Do you know what it is? I think I do. Of course you would. You're the greatest wielder of Pokemon this land knows. One who could bring low even Dialga and Palkia. This crumbling statue once was a figure of a Pokemon, one that was equal to both Dialga and Palkia. It vanished from our world. Great Pokemon Giratina was banished for its violence, left to dwell in a world on the reverse side of our own. It's a being that has lain in wait for the chance to bear its fangs in defiance and tear down Arceus itself. Now tell me, if this Giratina desires more than anything else to challenge mighty Arceus, do you think it might appear? Oh. I wanted to skip dialogue, but okay. Exactly. There's one closer to the heavens than any other place in history. Where did the space-time rift first open? I feel it. Getting closer to it and uncovering the secrets of this world. I dare say the excitement is loosening my lips more than it should, but... You see, ever since I was young, whenever I met with something painful or heartbreaking, I couldn't help but wonder why life was so unfair, why I was cursed to live through such things. Of course, I imagine we all go through something like that. Actually, I chose to direct all my energy into my own natural curiosity and ambition. I tickled my curiosity more strongly than anything. Mysteries to be found in legends, history, ruins. You see, I fancied that by unraveling these mysteries, I could find out how the world itself came to be. With that knowledge, maybe even forge a new, better world. Now, if we can find the realm that exists on the reverse side of our world, meet the creator's unwanted child banished therein, perhaps then we'll be able to understand the nature of Almighty Sinnoh itself. See with your own eyes. Must make for the Temple of Sinnoh at Mount Cornet's Peak. Dialga and Palkia both appeared from within that rift that gaped open there, didn't they? These plates can't call anything at all. It seems likely that's where it would appear. Just slowly scoots. Okay, thank you. temple lies in ruins now. Columns cracked and broken. Pillars now turned into spears, stabbing into the heavens. Well, I detect a distinct lack of Giratina. Something bothering you? I do beg your pardon. I suppose I must seem to be behaving strangely. Hearsay, you deserve to know what I'm really after by now. Ever since I became convinced that Arceus really does exist, there has been one question that consumed my thoughts. How did I meet such a being myself? It's an attempt to answer this question that I originally sought out Giratina and had it tear open that rift in space and time. After all, Giratina wished to stand against Arceus. That didn't do the trick. Then I had you gather the fragments of the all-encompassing deity, just as the murals of the ruins directed. 18 plates said to be the fragments of the all-encompassing deity. You hold in your hand 17 of them, so you must be wondering. Where is the last one? It's right here. What the fuck is up with your hair? Now hand over the plates you gathered. I will be the one to bring them all together. My desire to meet Arceus cannot be contained any longer. I need to know what it is. I must know what it is. I can eat Arceus myself, then I may also be able to subjugate its power. Using that, I will attempt to create a new, better world. Of course, I will create a brand new world, and this Hisui region that we currently exist in will be undone and return to nothing. You, everyone you know, and all the Pokémon living here will vanish in an instant, which you've never been. If you want to keep this world from disappearing, then face me in battle. If you don't wish to battle me, I'm not above using force to take those plates from you. Bruh, I'm gonna smash that ridiculous-looking hair. Spirit Tomb. Oh no, you're good. Oh, you live. Oh, you call back. Roserade? Alright. had a token kiss. Bastard. Lucario. Stupid-ass hairdo. Why? Why you? Why do you have the blessing of Arceus? This music's so good. Yeah, it is. Why? How? I devoted myself to Arceus beyond any other. Just look at my stupid fucking hair. I worship it as the creator of our entire world. I bet all of my passionate interest into its study. All the time I've spent poring over the legends, everything that I've done. You, outsider, it's almost as if you were spat out of the space-time rift just to get in my way. No, this isn't finished yet. Can you feel it? The chill creeping through your veins, the eldritch presence icing your heart. Oh no. I hate the BRB right back, but, I kinda have to. Alright, I'll be right back. I'm really sorry. that faces the bringer of death. Well, this dude don't want to die. Oh god, this one. Power, bro, you make a shit. Turning tail and running? It's puny human. Pathetic. I was the one that feed you the power you needed so you could take on Arceus. I was the one who gave you the chance to claw open that space-time rift, driving the deity of space and the deity of time mad so that you could drag the creator out from hiding. How could this happen? Almighty Arceus, if you have any heart within you, then tell me. The blood of the ancient Sinnoh people flows in my veins, does it not? What is it, then, that you find so lacking in me? That fucking hairdo. You mean to tell me that this world doesn't need to be remade? Oh, hold on, bear back. I can't live with such questions. I can't bear not satisfying this ache to know. Answer me then. You have some dream that propels you as I have? Yeah, sure, we gotta go with the basic protagonist answer. Now listen, that dream of yours would never leave room for the dreams of one like me. I am the great wielder of Pokemon, and you battle alongside your Pokemon. In the end, I was alone, but not you. We'll fight together with your Pokemon to seize whatever dreams you have. Here, take it. Take the plate that started me on this path. The plate I once received from Giratina. My journey is over. My story ended when I lost to you. Take the spooky plate from Volo. You with the essence of ghosts. Sorry, time. I suppose now you've gathered all the plates said to exist in this land of Hisui. What? Celestica flute transformed into the Azure flute. So that's it. The Azure Flute comes to you. So Arceus wishes to meet you of all people. You had to be one. Is that why you were brought into this world? No desire to watch from the sidelines as Arceus comes to you. I absolutely cannot escape a world in which you would ever manage to defeat Arceus. I'm sorry for dropping off every now and then. It's being pestered off the mic. Someday I'll solve every riddle in the Legends of Hisui's Pokemon. On that day, I'll stand before Arceus at last. No, I will conquer it. No matter how many years, how many decades, how many centuries it takes me. Thank you, Hotter-Tan. It's almost about dinner time. That's why I'm getting pestered a lot. Sorry about that. You have to look at his dumb fucking face. Anything happen if I do it? Shoot. Don't meet the requirements yet. All right. Well, beat Volo and Giratina and his dumb fucking haircut. I'm gonna call it here because it's been almost 4 hours and it's time to eat. But I think my next stream, I'm gonna get started on a Dark Cloud. I've never played it before, so I'm willing to give it a try. But thank y'all for joining. See you around, Hotter-Tan. Later. Hell yeah, Dark Cloud. Alright, later.